Proteins are everywhere in our bodies, and they can do lots of amazing things. Like tools, the shape of the protein is very important. For example, scissors have multiple blades that help it cut things, while screwdrivers have a shaped end that allow it to fit into a screw. Without the proper shape, the protein would not be able to perform its job. Proteins don't start out, though, in their final shape. To become the proper shape, proteins need to go through a process called protein folding. Proteins are made up of building blocks called amino acids. These amino acids are placed into chains known as polypeptides. To become the final protein, the polypeptide needs to fold into its proper shape. But how do proteins know which shape to fold into? Amino acids in a polypeptide follow a wide variety of rules to fold into the final protein. For example, some amino acids love water, while others dislike water, which can affect where those amino acids are placed in the protein. Other amino acids enjoy being close to each other and can form bonds so that they stay next to each other in the final protein. However, protein folding is incredibly complex, and there are many other rules to help ensure that proteins fold properly. Because proteins are everywhere in our body and perform many jobs, it is important that they fold into the proper shape. If proteins don't have the right shape, they can cause problems like clumping together. These problem proteins can play a role in diseases like Alzheimer's and mad cow disease. Luckily, our body has a number of ways to deal with misfolded proteins. They can get rid of the problem proteins or use proteins called chaperones to help fix and refold proteins into the proper shape. We're still learning so much about the exact rules for how proteins fold and how the shape of a protein can teach us about the job it performs. Understanding both of these can help us understand not only how proteins work, but how to treat diseases related to problems with protein folding.